Sagen Sie jetzt mal bitte
Anarchie.
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 Ob geschichtlich oder brandaktuell.
Mit Berichten und Interviews, mit Beiträgen und Collagen
beleuchtet das anarchistische Radio Berlin das Phänomen des Anarchismus.
Viva Anarchia!
In the following interview we made with a UK-based prisoner support activist, we talk about recent changes in judicial law, especially concerning legal aids and the introduction of so-called court costs, showing clearly an even more class-based judicial system.
Yeah, I think we all know about the intricate relationship between capitalism and the judicial system in, let's say, the Western part of the world. And now I'm here with a prisoner support activist from the UK. And yeah, I would like to know of you of a recent change in the legal system in the UK that might exemplarily show how this works.
Hi, I'm going to discuss a few things, mainly the court costs that were introduced in April of this year, 2015. But first of all, I'd like to talk about some preceding foundations for the economising of the legal system in England. In 2013, the Conservative government passed a bill to change legal aid in England, which made it incredibly difficult for people on low incomes and also a list of other situations to make it very difficult to get legal representation. And such things as divorce, welfare, benefits, employment, clinical negligence and housing law, all things which are disproportionately affect people from working class backgrounds and people on low incomes in England. The major reaction was from lawyers and people that work in the legal aid, because it makes it, they're still interested in doing this work and it's a large part of their workload, which means they can't get paid for it. So they actually went on strike, which was quite an interesting event. But it laid the foundation for removing the representation so that when they did bring in this bill that recently this year, it meant that there was not much resistance or a strong body to do anything about it. I mean, England's always been a class-based system with a strong bias against the large working class and people who don't have the ability to pay for it themselves and put the burden of responsibility on that person, i.e. you're not poor, you're just lazy. And the Conservative government has now recently passed with a majority much larger than was expected in the government, and now it's taken an opportunity to sort of run away with its ideological basis, which is that poor people are poor because they deserve it and rich people are rich because they deserve it. And so you withhold all the rights from poor people in order to make them work harder, in the theory that they will rise up the chain and become like the rich elite. It's affected activism majorly because obviously a lot of activists aren't very rich because they spend most of their time working on campaigns and in various different areas which don't generate any money. So if they were to be arrested, it's very difficult for them to get legal representation, and obviously the state has an interest in persecuting these people, so it makes it even easier, to the point where people, at best option, is to represent themselves. The English legal system is still very theatrical, there's still wigs and gowns, and it's still a different world, so unless you're trained in it, literally, then you have very little chance of accurately representing your case, even in very difficult circumstances. So this has been the case for a number of years now, and then in April of this year, they introduced something called court costs, which, as quoted from the government website, is that adult offenders who use the criminal courts should pay towards the cost of the running them. So they're saying that this is a service that we provide for you and that you should pay for it. And how they decide whether you should pay for it is if you're found guilty, and a sliding scale. So if it's a magistrate's court or a local court, then it's less. And they also say it's not based on the punishment. So if you're found guilty, they'll charge you a service cost based on the severity and the amount of time. So they're linking it to sort of like services. So you use a more expensive court, then you pay more money. And the costs go from £150 to £1,200. But within that as well, there's incentives to plead guilty. So if you plead guilty earlier, then you'll have to pay less money. And it's not a fine, it's just an out-and-out court cost, like a charge, kind of like a privatised healthcare system or something. What it obviously does is it incentivises people to plead guilty early and not go through the court process. But also the amount of money in terms of is relatively low if you're quite wealthy. But if you're on a low income, it's a massive amount of your salary, plus the disruption that going through a case is anyway. And it's very difficult. The majority of judiciary in England that isn't massively conservative in political ideology, although still they're very elitist, thinks it's a bad idea as well, because it is exactly that. It weights the justice system in one side on an already like one-sided system, and makes people who are already struggling in difficult circumstances their lives even harder. And it's a worrying trend, because if they remove the ability for people who are on low incomes or in difficult circumstances or do want to take action against the government, it makes it very difficult for them to continue that work or survive in a lot of cases. So they're just sort of like siphoning you off to say, okay, if you're poor and you can't afford this, you can go to prison because that's your options. Or you can just spend your entire life trying to pay off this debt that you've for even the most minor offence. As an activist that works in prisoner support, it just is very depressing to see people being put in this position.
So did you notice that this has been already applied to activists, and what was the reaction then and before the courts?
Well, through a personal case, although I won't mention any personal details, but a fellow activist of mine who was arrested at a public protest after the legal aid was changed, applied for legal aid, and due to the abstractions in the law, and even in the lawyer's own words, it was difficult to know at this point whether he would be able to get it. He was on a very low salary, and I think it was even below the threshold to get it. But because they've made it so difficult, he was under the awareness that he would get the money for legal aid, and then it turned out a few months later that they'd failed in their bill, and now he owed this like £2,000 of money. And he had to make a down payment within the next 2 weeks, otherwise potentially the fine would rise. He's still not fully aware if he'll get legal aid for the whole trial, and he doesn't also know how long the trial's going to be, so potentially he could be looking at a huge, huge amount of debt even before he go whatever he is prosecuted or imprisoned or whatever happens for that situation. So, and usually before that case, before 2013, it was quite simple that you would given legal aid, and there was usually a legal firm of relative quality that you could trust to do that work for you, and you knew that it was being done. So now if you are arrested in the UK, you have that. Also, you may not be able to get good representation. You might not even be able to get someone to accurately sum up the process that you're about to go through and say when you should speak, how you should speak to people. And like, the English court system is very dominated by kind of like routine and speak when you're spoken to. Address the judge properly. Like, this is all, it's very minor things, but if you're not aware of how to interact in that situation, you literally have no chance, and they can just pick you apart, and then you definitely lose the case. And it has a massive effect on the psychology of people, not necessarily when they approach these situations, but after, when they're going through the process and just feeling totally vulnerable with no ability to do anything about the situation.
Apart from being generally against this judicial system, is there any hope that this law might not prevail, or do you have the impression that things are going even to a worse direction?
I think they're going worse. The Conservative government we have at the moment is, in the last time when they introduced and initiated a lot of these laws, was in a coalition with another party that was more liberal, and now it's just them. And with all sorts of, particularly with like public spending, they're going on an ideological battle. And especially with welfare, after a crash that was where the money was pulled out of our economy by rich banks, they've seen it fit to the burden of that responsibility to be taken on unemployed people, and they're restricting benefits, and they're just putting people in situations where they have nowhere to go. And legal representation is one of the last hopes for people who have been totally fucked around by the government and like welfare systems. And it includes specifically in the legal aid bill that changes in housing law and employment law, which is things that directly affect massively these people. So, and they're just leaving them with no, it's difficult to imagine that any government would want to like leave a section of the population destitute, without the ability to work, without the ability to pay for their lives, without the ability to house or look after themselves or other people. So I don't think they're going to make the legal system any fairer. I mean, when you've got the judges and the lawyers revolting and saying this is too harsh, we don't want this, It's a very bad state of affairs. But you could see, I mean, during the strike, they were talking about the collapse of the potential legal system as we know it, because in theory in England it's meant to be a kind of independent body that has all its own authority and can influence the government as well as being influenced by the government. But even when they are powerless to the point where they have to go on strike, it's just it's a scary situation. Personally, I've never been a fan of the judiciary or the justice system in England anyway. I never believed in it much. But still, it's a system that we have to use and or try and survive. And when it gets harder and harder to survive, it directly affects people that I work with and myself.
Okay, many thanks and a lot of strength for the future work.
Thank you. Cheers.